So you pass one arm here, and you shake it off. I start with this hand. I pass. Go here. I'm just going up like this.
Granby, it's a good combination.
So here. I'm doing a swisher step like this. If I don't have that angle and I just try to cut, it's not the same. Okay? And then I'm catching this leg. My head is coming to this hip like this. I'm trying to force it, right? But if his legs are more like this, you just go off here, roll.
It's high level. Is it legit?
You fall on your hip, but you keep all the weight on the leg. If I don't keep the tension in the leg, you get back up. So if I'm like here, and I'm driving my shoulder constantly to the mat, if I'm not driving my shoulder to the mat and I'm up here, he flattens me out and brings me to my back. So as soon as you sit to the hip, you're just leaning forward. You got this tension on here, because now he's preoccupied with the seatbelt. He can't hand fight to a choke, right? Because that's the only thing holding on. If he lets go of the seatbelt, he doesn't have the back position anymore. So you pass one more here, and you shake it. Really interesting way to like defend when they have a single hook and the seatbelt. This position takes a while to like get used to when you start doing it, just like sitting down on it. This one, you just put your hand on your head to alleviate pressure. If I don't put my hand on my head, you can just crunch my head in it, and once you know where the head goes, the body follows. I do the same shit, and now I go here, here.
So before you go to the hand fighting, to get the underhook, you get your hip up, right?
No, you do the hand fight as you're hip sitting. I go here. I do the pass off, I go from here, this hand, just to go here, and then now I pull. When I'm pulling across here, I'm pulling really tight. If I don't pull tight enough, as I get up, he's just gonna chain it to a kind of katami or like whatever kind of guillotine he wants to do pretty much. So when I'm pulling this across my body, as I'm getting up, he tries to chain it to a guillotine. It's gonna be pretty hard. And then I could also just wrist grab defense, and I also have the head pommel working for me. Yeah. Once my head pommel is in the center line, I'm pretty safe, I'm not gonna get it. So you can mix this one with the other one soon. Just do this one for now. So I go here on my head, because sometimes they put so much pressure, maybe they're heavier than you. This is just gonna stop it, it's gonna buy you time. I hip sit, same position. I start with this hand, I pass, go here. Make sense?
Okay. So check this out, boom.
First?
You're doing the hip sit first,
so I'll
do it.
Yeah,
yeah,
so, yeah.
Just do that.
But then I can just go, because even if he does kind of crunch my head.
And I try to stand up, he can hang on me. And then as I stand up, he just got the hooks on, so you don't want to stand up to a seatbelt. When he has a seatbelt, I'm just going up like this. So I'm standing, but I'm cutting this angle. Here, I grab the tricep and I start to down. He's got a tight body lock. really basic drill, but you can see the importance of like knowing what to recognize, what to do. I'm not letting go of the hand just yet because like the scramble isn't done. Once I like have top control and I keep this hand, then I'm ready to just. This one works really well when they're in front headlock. Go front headlock. And they transition all the way to turtle. Because now look, see how they have that momentum against them? And especially when they overcommit that hand. So when you play a turtle offensively, that's something to keep in mind. Like, go here or just go thigh. But people don't really know that they go here, it's like a free gift a lot of the time. So you switch your step away. Because now I'm like going over this way. You could if you want, or you go far away.
And it's like, as long as you control their hip, then you're.
Yeah, as long as you're in the head, you don't want the hip to do it again. So if you went for this, but he didn't get that angle, he didn't do that switch step, just go for the roll. You can see how this could like. He doesn't have that pressure, he'd like it could easily, it could fail easier, right? But when he does that little step, yeah, now go.
Oh, because the angle's no longer just perpendicular, it's more,
yeah.
More parallel.
Somehow it just mechanically makes it a lot easier. Sleepy. It's probably like this is one of my go-tos I used before all the other
to here, and I'm like here.
Yeah, and then you scoop this, and like.
You know how possibly you can do that other one? This is just your. You want to put the deep one, you just kind of knees together.
So you're like. I think you're going over my knee.
Maybe transition a turtle. They're not really yet. Like that's why I find for me. Like, if they're settled, it's not gonna be as.